Kalamata was one of the best freediving experiences I've ever had, which will surprise a lot of people to hear because I announced 3 world records and came away with none. In hindsight, the experience of failure was probably the most, it gave me the most insight and the most clarity and the most liberation in terms of my understanding of my diving that I've ever had. The experience of failing, or the perceived experience of failing, actually made me question why I was still so happy and enjoying my time there. And I realized that the world records themselves, the titles, aren't important. And I remembered my goal at the beginning of this year was to get back to deep diving, irrespective of the numbers, irrespective of whether I hit 100 or not, and just do amazing, joyful dives. And that's what I had already achieved in Dahab before going to Greece. Amazing dive I think I've ever done. My final training dive before Kalamata, and I did 104, and it really was incredibly easy. The equalization was my only limiting factor, and certainly on the surface I was very clean and very strong and could have gone further. So yeah, beautiful, positive way to finish my training for this year. I think failure can be actually the biggest teacher. If we always succeed, we don't get a chance to get perspective on our goals and our motivation. And I think it's very easy in freediving to get caught up in the numbers and to not really understand if that's what drives us or if the motivation is something more personal and spiritual in terms of being at one with the ocean and just having a beautiful experience. So this is what the failure has taught me, that it actually was the greatest success.